So, I just found this culvert. It's quite a nice culvert. Looking at the head walls, you see the colour of them. Well, for reference of age, concrete starts to turn dark after 45, 50 years. So, this is probably about 50-year-old concrete here. At least the head walls. Or, to be precise, these are the wing walls. That would be the head walls. Concrete doesn't go on for long as it reaches a brick abutment, basically. Obviously bricks that have been vitrified during manufacture to basically get rid of any permeability. So let's enter. Okay. Ceiling's about 5 foot tall in here, and it seems like it's getting shorter. I want a drink. I just went back out to get a drink of water. The first thing I see on the RCC ceilings is this steel column, obviously load bearing. The aggregate of the concrete is about 40 millimeters. You know what you just heard then? That was a manhole cover. There's obviously a lateral line in here with a manhole that a car drives over. It makes a big noise. Wood lice living in there. It seems for some reason the ceiling is getting shorter, but I don't know if that's just me and my very bad back or something else. Wonder what this is. Patch of brick. It's probably just, yeah, that looks like some IOB, aka iron oxidizing bacteria that used to be here and died. Possible infiltration, and also causing a bit of effervescence, that infiltration up. Yeah, more. Turned a bend around here. Where we've got hydraulic erosion control channel here. Basically, like a channel, not really a box shaped floor, but like a channel. Also a lateral line here. I wonder what that is. Runs up to a manhole cover here. I'm just gonna stand up here. Whoa, what the is this? Like a big metal can. What on earth? Probably baffle. What the hell is this for? Nice. The wood grain that was used to cast the concrete is visible here. Wood grain. Concrete wood grain. All around. Got the lateral line there. I think that's the one with the loud manhole cover. So yeah, and these are either wrought iron or they are steel. Most likely steel. In the old days they used to be wrought iron. Yeah, you know why I think steel? Because the same material that was used to build the rebar. Obviously much cheaper than wrought iron. And quite a lot of spiders here. I've got a lateral line here, about 10 inches diameter. Probably made of asbestos reinforced concrete pipe, and it flows the direction of the water. This is known as the interception angle, and basically reduces discharge resistance coefficient. I think they actually use these steel girders to reinforce this concrete structure. One sec. There we go. The torch is a little bit brighter now. I can zoom my torch into places I want. Another lateral line upcoming. It's darkness now. Complete darkness in here. Lateral line. Quite dilapidated, full of sediment. That tells me that that does not flow very often. And there's bits of calcium precipitate. Calcium. What material is this? Some strong pipe. Probably been cast iron pipe. Some rebar. Yeah, that is calcium infiltration. A lot of calcium precipitation here. A percentage of this is also efflorescence, where minerals are leached out the concrete. You see a wood grain again of what they used to cast the concrete with. Iron oxidizing bacteria leaching out the walls. Darkness. this. A dip. Ah, a nice lateral line here. This is vitrified clay pipe. Quite a nice gradient in this one too. A bit of water coming out too. That's the sound of a manhole cover just then. Another large lateral line here. This wasn't a very good job. Well, now I look again, it was a good job actually. Never mind. Now this is reinforced concrete, this one. A lot of sediment in there. And another lateral line here. The classic reinforced concrete. Classic reinforced concrete with some iron oxidizing bacteria. It's harmless to humans, iron oxidizing bacteria is actually. Another manhole chamber with rungs. Oh, a lot of spiders in here, but manhole cover. I'm gonna have a rest here. I'm gonna get a drink of water. Then I've got to continue my walk. Well, my rest is finished. Gonna move on. Another lateral here. Cast iron, probably about 3 inches diameter with a lot of iron oxidizing bacteria coming out and other stuff. Lateral lines, about 6 inch diameter, 150 millimeters. And these big lumps, they're concrete that has been put down the drain and by construction workers in the past and not cleared out properly. So basically what the structure is a basically a trash rack, quite an articulated trash rack, so they can fit people through this hatch. Where is the hatch? Here. This hatch is on hinges obviously and can open if unlocked. They also have this huge area here where they can get cranes, remove these bolts and crane down a like a excavator. And these are all modularized steel beams and columns, so yeah, they could easily be removed for good maintenance. Even got a stairway down here with a terrace here with a box that's obviously filled with equipment. Well, it's just a yellow grit box, basically. Look at this canal, though. Look at this view. Got a penstock valve over there, basically a check valve. Got some more walkways down there. We're open Monday to Friday, 6 a.m. midnight, Saturday 6 a.m. 10 p.m. Oh, they didn't clear out the trash rack. Okay, running back through then. So they basically got steel girders here. No, these are galvanized iron. They're columns and they go all this way on these structures, which are known as abutments, and they're parallel. See where the water flows in and hits this omitted point, which was during the rechanneling of the stream when the Asda was built, which is a shop up there. Bricks there, bricks. A probably granite there, I hope it is. Extremely hard concrete, hydraulic erosion resistant concrete there, on here, and on there, of course. A little gradient, really. Got the omit point. The bricks. Here we go. Cast iron lateral line, 3 inches. Vitrified clay pipe, 150mm diameter. Another one there. Possibly a road gully. It's got to be, and there's some iron oxidizing bacteria on the wall. Lateral line here, obviously prefabricated, comes into about a 45 degree bend here. Close enough. Outfall here, a bigger pipe here, much larger one. Doesn't look like it was installed really correctly, but it's up to code. I think I see an operating lateral line over here. Here we go. This lateral line is now operating. I wonder what this could be, really. So yeah, when it comes to these lateral lines, I have a story of these lateral lines. So basically, it was January 12th, 2020. So more than 2 years ago, I was in a huge culvert system or subsurface canal called the River Monterosa, or Rio Monterosa for Spanish. And it was in Spain, and the subsurface canal was unbelievably long, about 1.16 kilometers long. And I was walking through this canal. The river that flowed through it, the Monterosa River, was as dry as anything in this culvert I was walking through. And then I'd be going through the center part. And then suddenly, about 25, 50, meters behind me was like a lateral line that was discharging suddenly. And it wasn't this short, it was, the lateral line was at a height taller than these ceilings. And it would, the water fell down onto the floor going, and oh, that really jumped me when the lateral lines start to discharge out at random times. They really have a mind of their own. It really kind of shocks you until you've gotten used to it. And that's happened to me many a times. So that's basically my story in these lateral lines. And you just heard a manhole cover. I must admit, I'm a person that quite prefers the taller ones to this. Oh well, just have a rest like this. A lot of water bugs living in that sediment. I wonder what they are. They're little flies, I think. That's why you get a hard hat on. Hard hat, so some very bad headaches don't occur, or even concussions when you're standing up really quickly. That lateral line, cast iron probably. Spider webs in my face. Stand up. Damn, my back hurts. I still don't know what this is. Probably never find out. Well, let's go. So as you can see here, the high velocity flow is converted into a low velocity flow with this energy dissipation area, where the hydraulic mean depth is much higher than the actual invert, and it's obviously to prevent erosion of the banks, minimize it of course. Thank you.